Hello, thank you for the opportunity to speak to you. I'm currently in New Zealand, so it's actually Saturday morning in spring due to the vagaries of the dateline and the equator. You can also see that we're talking about a 21-year-old journey, and the photo on the screen is from a time when I had a little more hair and could find a necktie. This is my only disclosure. Just a bit of context background to this project. In New Zealand, we're in a slightly different regulatory framework, and fresh gas flows with sevoflurane are not an issue. And we've had access to machines with automated control of end tidal concentrations for a little over 10 years now. We made some choices early on, and the photo is not of our earliest setup, but it does show some of the technology we used for data collection, probably about 15 years ago now. We chose to use time-weighted fresh gas flow as a marker of consumption and to include the entire time that volatile was being used. We also focused on sevoflurane initially just to make the calculations easy to not have to deal with MAC equivalents and the like. It's remained our, fortunately, remained our predominant volatile. We have tracked our volatile choices over the years in other ways. Just a reminder that the maintenance fresh gas flow is not the same as your average fresh gas flow, and in particular that high flow periods, especially around the beginning of the case, can have a massive effect on the overall average and therefore on the vapor consumption. Here's our summary of the past 21 years. We've used different enabling technologies at different stages in this project. For the last 4 years, we've been getting data from the production version of GE Insights, which allows us to look in detail. For the 9 months to September of this year, our mean fresh gas flow was 760 mils a minute, and that represents around about 13 mils of sevoflurane per case. That's where we've got to. There's where we've come from. Because we're getting a lot more data now, we can also track the use of Teva. Here's about a little over 4 years of data. We're currently sitting at around about 60% of all our cases are Teva. We can also drill down and look at the patterns in different rooms. On the x-axis, you've got the time-weighted fresh gas flow. On the y-axis, the proportion of Teva. You can see that there's a bit of a spread across there. But what's interesting is when we have two rooms that have the same type of work having quite different patterns of use. These are the interesting ones that I want to focus on, 39 and 40, which are GI acute rooms. They've got a similar case mix, but there are differences in a number of the parameters that we look at. And the only real difference between the rooms is 40 is seldom used out of hours. So we split the data for the two rooms and looked at the working hours against the rest of the time, with somewhere between three to over 300 cases in each room that used volatile anesthetics. And what we found was the original suggestion confirmed and in fact exaggerated that the fresh gas flow is significantly lower in out-of-hours work than it is in-hours, and that's when a time when our staffing is a lot tends to be more junior with trainees and residents giving the majority of the anesthetics at that time. So in summary, here's our sequence of flows over 21 years of looking at this. A low flow culture is embedded in what we do. Our progress has been really via general data and education than specific cajoling. The technology has, of course, helped us along this journey. What's reassuring is that despite the increased use of Teva, trainees can give an economical volatile anesthetic. There's always room for improvement. We've got a few projects going on with our pediatric group and also getting into some of those other differences between rooms where we might be able to optimize things a little further. And of course, the state we've got to with our vapor use, it suggests that other projects around the department and the hospital may have bigger effects on CO2 and dollar savings. Thank you for your attention, and I look forward to any questions you might have.